Hi everyone, Syed here. I hope you are doing well. You know, PowerPoint slides are very important because you are going to present all the hard works you have done in a short amount of time. So if you fail to impress your audience, they would think that you have done a weak job. Let me ask you a question. Which one of these intros do you think can impress your audience? This one or this one? Today I'm going to show you how to design the second intro in PowerPoint, and you can download the template for free in the description. So let's design it together. First, click on the layout and select the blank slide. Then from the insert tab, add this shape to the slide. Since I want a square shape, I have to hold the shift key down while I'm drawing. Now set 2.5 for the height and width. Make some copies of it and adjust them like this. Don't forget to hold the shift key down if you want to transform your shape on a straight line. Now select all the shapes and make them union. Bring your picture to the slide and send it back. Now rotate your shape to the angle you want, then duplicate it and put it exactly in the same position. I will explain why we duplicated it later. Anyway, hold the Ctrl key down and select the picture and one of the shapes. Then from the Shape Format tab, in the Merge Shapes section, select the fragment from the list. Now we have to delete the extra shapes. But before that, let me tell you why we duplicated the shape earlier. If we hadn't done that, we couldn't see the new shapes borders, and deleting the extra ones would be kind of impossible. So the presence of this shape will help us to delete them without any problem, especially when we have complicated shapes. Okay, we don't need this shape anymore, so I can delete it. If you look at the slide precisely, there is a piece that is a little hard to see, and we have to delete it as well. Perfect. Let's add a drop shadow to all the pictures. So press Ctrl A to select all the pictures, then right click on one of them and select Format Object. In this window, add the drop shadow in this direction and also set the blur amount to 25, distance to 12, and transparency to 30%. Now click on the background, then by using the eyedropper tool, choose this color for the background. Again, draw this shape and adjust it like this. Set the height and width to 6. Remove its outline and choose a dark green for the shape fill. From the Insert tab, select the text box and add your title to the slide. Also, add this title. For this text, I want to increase the spacing between characters. To do that, select the character spacing icon and click on more spacing. In this window, while the expanding option is selected, type number 8 in this box, then click on OK. Perfect. Let's add a drop shadow to the text. Select both text boxes and from text option tab, add a drop shadow in this direction and set the blur amount to 8 and distance to 5. Okay, so far so good. Now we are going to animate it. First, duplicate the slide and in the first slide, select all the pictures and align them to the middle and center. Then drag them to the outside. Also, rotate this shape and drag it to the outside in this direction. And delete the text boxes. Now bring your image to the slide and crop it. From Picture Format tab, click on the Artistic Effects icon and choose this effect. Draw a rectangle, then choose the background color for it and change its transparency to 25%. Add your titles to the slide, then select the second slide and add Morph Transition to it. Since I want to see the titles after transition, select them and add fade animation to both of them. and select Start After Previews in this section. For the last step, since I want to animate the first slide with morph transition, I have to copy all the items inside the first slide, then paste them in the second slide. And while all of them are selected, drag them to the outside. Now your slides are ready. Before we see the final result, if you think this video was helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's see the final result.